Good evening. Welcome to worship here at Trinity Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Madeline Burbank, and I welcome you to our community. We are focusing on growing as a community dedicated to God and each other and our community around us. If at any point you need hearing assistive devices or large printouts of the words that we'll be saying tonight, you can find those in the narthex, the area behind the sanctuary, and you can ask around for help if you need find bathrooms or anything that you might need. Tonight we will be going through a celebratory order of worship. There will be communion, and there will be announcements at the end highlighting our upcoming God's Work, Our Hands Day of Service. But for now, we center ourselves and ready our hearts and open with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love endures forever. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not followed your path, but have chosen our own way. Instead of putting others before ourselves, we long to take the best seats at the table. When met by those in need, we have too often passed by on the other side. Set us again on the path of life. Save us from ourselves and free us to love our neighbors. Amen. Hear the good news. God does not deal with us according to our sins, but delights in granting pardon and mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are free to love as God does love. Amen. We open with our hymn, Gather Us In, number 532 in your cranberry hymnal.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Stand, we rise with our hearts and sit in contemplative prayer as we pray together aloud. O God, you resist those who are proud and give grace to those who are humble. Give us the humility of your Son, that we may embody the generosity of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Our first reading comes from the book of Jeremiah, the second chapter. Hear the word of the Lord, O house of Jacob, and all the families of the house of Israel. Thus says the Lord, what wrong did your ancestors find in me that they went far from me and went after worthless things and became worthless themselves? They did not say, where is the Lord who brought us up from the land of Egypt and who led us in the wilderness in a land of deserts and pits, in a land of drought and deep darkness, in a land that no one passes through and where no one lives? I brought you into a plentiful land to eat its fruits and its good things. But when you entered, you defiled my land and made my heritage an abomination. The priests did not say, where is the Lord? Those who handle the law did not know me. The rulers transgressed against me. The prophets prophesied by Baal and went after things that do not profit. Therefore, once more, I accuse you, says the Lord, and I accuse your children's children. Cross to the coast of Cyprus and look. Send to Kedar and examine with care. See if there has ever been such a thing. Has a nation changed its gods, even though they are no gods? But my people have changed their glory for something that does not profit. Be appalled, O heavens, at this. Be shocked, be utterly desolate, says the Lord. For my people has committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living water, and dug out wells for themselves, broken wells that can hold no water. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. we read responsively from Psalm 112. Hallelujah! Happy are they who fear the Lord and have great delight in God's commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches will be in their house, and their righteousness will last forever. Light shines in the darkness for the upright. The righteous are merciful and full of compassion. It is good for them to be generous in lending and to manage their affairs with justice, for they will never be shaken. The righteous will be kept in everlasting remembrance. They will not be afraid of any evil rumors. Their heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. Their heart is established and will not shrink until they see their desire upon their enemies. They have given freely to the poor, and their righteousness stands fast forever. They will hold up their head with honor. The wicked will see it and be angry. They will gnash their teeth and pine away. The desires of the wicked will perish. A reading from Hebrews, the 13th chapter. Let mutual love continue. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without even knowing it. Remember those who are in prison as though you were in prison with them, those who are being tortured as though you yourselves were being tortured. Let marriage be held in honor by all, and let the marriage bed be kept undefiled, for God will judge fornicators and adulterers. Keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you or forsake you. So we can say with confidence, the Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can anyone do to me? Remember your leaders, those who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Through him, then, let us continually offer a sacrifice of praise to God. That is the fruit of lips that confess his name. Do not neglect to do good and to share what you have, for such sacrifices are pleasing to God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our gospel reading comes from the book of Luke, the 14th chapter. On one occasion, when Jesus was going to the house of a leader of the Pharisees to eat a meal on the Sabbath, they were watching him closely. When he noticed how the guests chose the places of honor, he told them a parable. When you are invited by someone to a wedding banquet, do not sit down at the place of honor in case someone more distinguished than you has been invited by your host. And the host who invited both of you may come and say to you, give this person your place. And then in disgrace, you'd have to start and take your place at the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit down at the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, friend, move up higher. Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at the table with you. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. He said also to the one who had invited him, when you give a luncheon or a dinner, do not invite your friends or your brothers or your relatives or your rich neighbors, in case they may invite you in return and you would be repaid. But when you give a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind, and you will be blessed because they cannot repay you, for you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous. The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. There are so many times that God's people journey in the wilderness. And we have the big one where Moses and the people are escaping slavery, are escaping the spears and the torture and the labor exploitation under Pharaoh, and are off to a land that flows with milk and honey, But first, they are crossing through pits and deserts, dry land and snakes, things that feel unfamiliar. But here in Jeremiah, we have the reminder that there are so many other times that people experience the wilderness, when they turn from God, when they are filled with doubt, when there are things like debt and poverty and divorce and suffering and sickness and things that maybe people could have taken a couple steps differently, but maybe they're there through no fault of their own, feeling confused and feeling alone and cursing God and wondering how they even got there. So in these moments of wilderness that we have in our own lives and that we see echoed throughout these stories, we have this reminder that God was with us all the while. And the people who hurl obstacles our way are not God. And the snakes and pits in our path are not God. But God will take our hand and guide us as much as possible. And we must lift each other up. We cannot be the ones throwing stones at each other, but protecting and shielding each other. Which is easy to think about, but we see how much easier it is in real life to get caught up in these other pits of self-aggrandizement, of hoping to invite the rich neighbor over so that we can get invited to whatever that pool party potluck is where everybody gets to drive the Corvette next year. Instead, Jesus is saying, when you are sharing, make sure you're sharing without expecting anything in return. Don't be doing this mental calculus about how it's going to improve your rankings, because then you're not sharing at all. That is not generosity. That is not righteousness. Righteousness is not perfection. Righteousness is the ability to just be vulnerable and put yourself out there in that sharing, in doing justice even when it involves risk, in serving others even if they might never be able to repay you, knowing that they never really could repay you, because the repayment that we get is a reward in the kingdom of God, in this commonwealth in which we all share, in this family where God places a hand on each of our shoulders and tells us that we are chosen and we are family and we shall never be alone. Coming up on the anniversary of the tragedy of 9/11, I'm thinking about times like that time, even when I was 7 years old all those years ago, where I was glued to the television set looking for answers. It felt that way when COVID was first brewing, and now as we have war on an international scale and threats of nuclear meltdowns and famine going on, it's easy to turn to the news looking for answers. I have friends who are dealing with painful medical diagnoses, having to change the food that they eat or cancer treatments that they get, and it's easy to go to Google and try to Google what their symptoms are, what the latest treatment is, trying to find answers. Losing sight that the way that we show up for each other, that's the meal, that's the generosity, that's the accompaniment that people are longing for. And when I'm sitting at the news looking for some comfort, some way to feel like the world's more in my control, I'm digging that well in the middle of the desert where God's already said, there's no water there. What are you doing? I guided you to follow me, and here is the river, here is the ever-flowing fountain of water, and here you're digging a well to nowhere. Get up and continue to follow me instead of sticking your shovel down and digging deeper into what feels familiar and what feels safe and like it might provide immediate answers, when there is mystery and question marks, but the promise of God's salvation when we continue to journey together and continue to invite others along. So all the times that we are lost in the wilderness and feeling alone, I appreciate moments like this where scripture is put into conversation with itself, where we have stories of people in the wilderness and stories of people with bounty. Pharisees inviting Jesus over so that they can size him up a little better, see if he'll slip, see if he'll say something wrong. And he flips the table on them by telling them a parable, exactly what they are doing in that moment. So in addition to inviting people and sharing, we can also bear this witness by pointing out what's going on around us. Not digging a well, digging to a bottomless pit for answers and for water that is not there, but for joining hands with those who will follow us and point out the foolish behavior of those who are jockeying for positions around a table that is a circle and everybody has a place at. So for that reminder, on this day and all days, I say thanks be to God. Amen. We sing together, Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross, number 335. Together we say the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, and died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Together we pray for our community here at Trinity and around the world. After I say, Merciful God, everyone responds, Receive our prayer. Awesome God, unite our lives with dedication toward you, toward this righteousness where we invite people to the table without expectation of being repaid, with trust in your abundance, and your ability to connect us above status, above family bond, above any preconceived notions about who belongs. You take your seat at the table and invite us around you and remind us that we all belong. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of connection, empower those who are performing service projects this Sunday, God's Work Our Hands Sunday. On this coming Sunday and all upcoming days where we dedicate our hands, our minds, our creativity, our dreaming of the future, our ability to put in some sweat and hard work to take care of each other, bless the labor of that work and continued service, which we continue to dedicate in Jesus' name. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of comfort and abiding strength, be with all those who are navigating heartbreak, sickness, addiction, uncertainty, instability, and healing. We pray for Eric, for Keith, for Irving, for Ron, for Dan, and for those we name before you now out loud and in our hearts. Receiving these names and all the names written upon our hearts, bring your comfort, healing, and care to all those we name before you, God. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of restoration, we pray for the people of Jackson, Mississippi, for the people of Pakistan, for all those affected by infrastructure calamity, by natural disaster, by the woes of climate change, the perils of war and famine. Empower people to bring connections and solutions that overcome all adversity, so that all people may have shelter, water, food, healing, and constant reminders of your everlasting stream of abundance in our lives. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God, we lift these prayers and all the prayers of our daily lives, our sleepless nights, and our restful times up to you. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you all. From your pew, wave and make a sign of peace to your neighbors. In a moment, we'll sing our offering response as ushers bring forward the offering that was collected as people entered the sanctuary for worship. Remembering that we give with joy as we are able, not only financially, but of the gifts of our hands, of our labors, of our relationships, of the wisdom that we have to share with one another. And for all these things, we respond with this offering. Together we pray. Lord, we entrust you through this church what you first given to us, some of our money, of our time, of our giftedness. We give as an expression of faith in you, trusting that it will be used to feed people, both physically and spiritually. Trusting that by these gifts, our children will know they are your children. May your rule, your way, and your love be known. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us thank our God. It is right to give God our thanks and praise. It is right for us to thank and praise you, God, even as people are aching for peace and healing, even wonderfully as the magnitude of your grace and love astound us. Even as we feel uncertain in our faith, we still praise you. You transform us each time we open ourselves to you, God. By this bread and wine, body and blood, the real presence of Jesus Christ, change us. Strengthen us to follow you. Make us remember the amazing love you show us, even in a time of betrayal, corruption, and fear, which Jesus himself knew all too well. On the night he was betrayed by a friend, Jesus nevertheless took bread from the table and gave thanks, breaking it apart so that everyone present could have some, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Jesus also took the cup, gave thanks, and shared it, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." We do remember, O God, we believe and trust as best we can, so we return again and again to this meal, this feast in miniature, to experience your enormous love and your presence. Amen. Together we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Everyone is invited to this table. Come forward as your ushers dismiss you, and if you'd like us to come to you in the pew, you can let your ushers know or give us a wave. There are gluten-free and juice options available in addition to the bread and wine. Come experience the love and presence of God. All are welcome. Life-giving God, through this meal you have bandaged our wounds and fed us with your mercy. Now send us forth to live for others, both friend and stranger, that all may come to know your love. This we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. As we prepare for God to send us out to serve, to love, and to live, we have a moment of announcements. God's work, our hands, is finally here this Sunday. So there will be a beautiful worship service. Typically this happens outside. I'm hearing there might be some rain happening. But come for worship either way at 9 a.m. and we're going to have a lot of fun and a lot of good music. It's band Sunday, so we're going to kick it up a notch with the awesome music. And then following worship, there will be a shared meal together. And then whatever service projects we'll be able to continue, we might be doing the ones that are inside in the fellowship hall and rescheduling ones that are outside in case of uncertain weather conditions, but there will be service projects happening, and if you don't have time to stick around for the service, come for the meal. Come for whatever parts you get to participate in, and we get to continue to celebrate the spirit of service and connectedness in our community. Sunday is also a big day because we're having blessing of the backpacks. So this is especially for those who are in elementary school, middle school, high school. If you're back in college and have a backpack or work bag, if you're, you know, 87 and said, "Hey, I'm starting my pottery class, I would also like to bless my backpack," bring it on by. Sunday we're having blessing of the backpacks, and we're very excited to have a laying on the hands and excitement for back to school and continued lifelong learning for all who gather. Also this Sunday is the food drive that Lyft is having, so you can bring any non-perishable items for the food drive and we will have a bin ready to collect those items. Bell Choir starts not this Sunday, but the next Sunday following worship, so about 10:15 a.m. And choir is now happening Wednesdays at 7 p.m. So with the start of the programming year being aligned with the start of the school year, we all have the back-to-school energy of choir is happening, bell choir is happening. There's service projects and lots to get involved with. Maybe you are regularly involved. Maybe you used to be involved and are finding ways to get back into it. Maybe you've never done something out besides worship at church and want to learn how to take those first steps, definitely come talk to me or anybody else and we will get you connected where you need to be. Are there any other announcements from the community at large? Great, then we will continue with this blessing. Nourished body and soul by the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, go out into the world assured of God's presence with you in the wilderness and in the land that is flowing with milk and honey. Wherever you might find yourself, you are not alone. Go in peace, love your neighbor. Thanks be to God.